Hello. I don't know if you can see all of these bags. Probably won't mean much to you at the moment, but it'll become more apparent when I explain that inside these bags, there are turkeys, chickens, there's some vegetarian options. And what we've got here is there's 3,000 bags. And you can just start to get some sort of a concept of what's happening here today. Now, last year we did a basket brigade where we fed, well, we did 1,050 baskets for people that are in a position that's, you know, less than suitable for the Christmas holidays. And we wanted to try and help them, to try and alleviate some of the stress and pressure. So what we did is we got together, there's a big group of people, and we did this thing called Basket Brigade, where we donate throughout the year, and then we'd all come together at Christmas in the 23rd of December, like today, and we put all these hampers together, and then we deliver them to people in and around London. Now, the reason I'm showing you this is because these are the deliveries that we started. I'm going to take you inside, and I'm going to show you exactly what's happening, so you can see, whilst this is going on, the 3,000 baskets that are being made today. That's 3,000 hampers that are being made inside to go out to around London. We're looking to feed 12,000 people this year. 12,000 people. And this is from a couple of people that had an idea, that wanted to do good, that wanted to help people, and it's grown and it's got bigger and more people have become involved. And as you can see, just by this, the sort of scale of what we're dealing with. So please, come with me, let's go inside and let's have a look. So as you can see, there's a few people with some of the rubbish, because obviously there's a lot of rubbish today. There's a lot of cardboard boxes, a lot of packaging. So we've got a horde of elves that are helping to clear everything up, to keep everything clean so we can move in and out, which is absolutely fantastic. We've got a help desk, there's a registration desk here. Do we know how many people roughly have signed up today? Over 600 people have signed up today. If you look around the room, you might just be able to get some sort of an idea of what 600 volunteers look like on a Monday morning. Now, this is quite spectacular when you realise that all of the efforts throughout the year to raise the money for the Basket Brigade, it's all for today. In a couple of hours, we'll be on the streets of London handing these hampers out to some of the, you know, some very deprived areas and people that are really struggling at this time of year. So what we're doing, it's absolutely amazing. The guys have been absolutely amazing, as you can see. This is just to give you some sort of an idea of the stock. If you get an idea, I mean, I don't know how many Brussels sprouts are there, but Ben, this is for the world record attempt. You're going to consume these later, aren't you?
I'm going to count these in 1 hour. That's my challenge.
That's your challenge, and I'm going to eat them in 30 minutes. And we'll see what happens. Brussels, potatoes, I mean, there's hardly anything left now, but if you could have seen this earlier, there were pallets and pallets. This is just a part of what's happening. I mean, if you take a look on the tables, and I think we should get involved and go and look around, but this is where all the production's going on, where they're making up the hampers, and it's just amazing to see everyone coming together and working together. How's it all going, everyone?
Yeah.
Enjoyed it?
Yeah.
So what are we making here then? These are threes and fours. So what we've done is we've got the families into sizes. So whether it's one person living on their own or a family of eight, we're looking to help people all shapes and sizes. And for that reason, we're making different things. There's vegetarian options, there's meat options. And what we're basically doing at the moment is we're making different family sizes. They're being made up with the quantities that are needed, and then they're having a little marker put on them, and they're being put into the staging area. So this is just one of the tables. I think if we go and have a look at a couple of other areas, you'll see, you start to get an idea of just what's going on. How's everyone doing? You all right?
Good.
Having a good time? There's kids here as well. There's some amazing children. In fact, I'm going to speak to one of the girls now. Hi, how you doing? You all right? You having a good time? Where are the kids gone? There were some children here earlier on the table. I found them, they're on that table. I was looking for them. Hello. How are you finding it today?
It's really good.
Are you enjoying it?
Yeah. And I'm really hot.
You're really hot? Why? Have you been making a lot of baskets?
Yeah, but I've been carrying them all the way.
What, over there? How many have you made so far, do you reckon?
I don't know, probably more than 10.
How many baskets have you made, do you reckon?
How many?
30? No wonder you're warm. You're enjoying it though, yeah?
Yeah?
Amazing. So there's kids here from as young as 1, 2 years old, all the way up to, well, teenagers that are helping out. I know they'd rather be elsewhere. But it's, I can't explain. It's just such a great atmosphere because everyone, you can walk up to a random table and people go, "How you doing? You all right?" You just don't get that when you walk around London. It's quite a unique environment to have that. You see some of the kids that are helping out. It's absolutely amazing. Sorry, darling. We'll get out of the production area and we'll go over to the staging area and I'll show you what's happening.
You are the champions. No time for losers. Because we are the champions of the world.
I can't see.
No, I've taken my bows and my curtain cold. And you bought me fame and fortune and everything that was of it. Oh, hang on. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of... Hang on, I've got to sing, sorry. Oh, did you turn it up?
I hope you're getting this. It's got to go on YouTube.
There it is. But it's been no bed of roses. No pleasure cruise. Ready? I consider it a challenge before home, human race. But I never lose. I think it all down. Ready? Here we go.
We are the champions. My friend,
come help me, please. Call my mum.
Jada! And we'll keep on fighting till the end. Sing, you know this song? Because we are the champions. Woo! Right, okay. I'll do the interview now. I don't do this song. What are you asking me?
So, spoke to you earlier, and you obviously told everyone what was going on. How is it now compared to when it was earlier? How are you feeling, and how is the day going for you in your eyes?
Well, when you spoke to me earlier, the food was just coming in. So obviously we had the human food chains going on. And obviously people didn't realise what they were going to be doing when they arrived because there's a lot of new people here. But now, as you can see, the room is under full string. It's packed. Half the room is packed. And there's probably about 85% of the other half that's been cordoned off for hampers has nearly been full. So that means shortly the summer hampers will be going out shortly because we need the space to then do the next lot of hampers. I'm overwhelmed with how many volunteers are here. I really have got no idea. I would probably say about 600 at the moment, and people are coming in throughout the morning and then the afternoon to go and do their deliveries today. So yeah, so just totally in awe of everyone, and it's just incredible. Sorry,
I didn't go up there. So with what's happened today so far, and obviously everyone's going to be going out, how do you feel? Because last year you did 1,050 baskets. This year we've got well over 3,000. We have over 600 people in the room and what is potentially an absolute logistical nightmare. But, and there's a big but, we're pulling it off very successfully. How do you feel?
I feel very calm. I'm not stressed at all. Nothing phases me. When I stood on stage at the beginning of January, I said the goal would be 2,000, but deep in my heart, I knew we'd be doing 3,000. Because we did fundraising throughout the year, we had skydiving going on, three or four skydives. We had over 100 people walk the O2. We've had many different fundraising events throughout the year. About 3 months ago, I knew that it was going to be more than 2,000. And I knew it was going to be 3,000, because when I set myself a target, I'll do it. And I do it in such a fashion that I exceed it and go way and above and beyond. And I've had so much support from everybody that whatever I need the photography, whether I need it videoed, whether I need 3,000 puds collected from about 30 people all over London, whether I need 3,000 people to pack their... we've had to have people take food into their house because Sainsbury's, their food order for us was too big for them to deliver. So that's a huge quality problem to be turned down with a huge order. But they come up trumps and, I had to ask friends to take the food into their houses. So, without those people, I don't know what I'd have done. But, I just put a message out on Facebook and it's done really. So it's not just about me. I've got the people that back me and care about what we're doing to go out and make a difference to all them families. And as I said earlier, yes, it's about the families, but over half the people in this room have never done this before. So they're going to have an experience like nothing else when they go and deliver this afternoon. And, you know, for me, I've done it, this is my 11th year, so I've done it and I've seen both sides of the story. And, you know, it's great to see what the reactions are of the families when they deliver and they don't know who it's from. And these are people that have got no money, literally. And it's just so, when I saw some of the stories, I'd be in tears. And, you know, I sit down with my family at Christmas, as we all do, and we've all got our own things going on in this in our lives, but at least we know we've made a difference and we've touched the heart of over 3,000 people, families, and that's probably about 12,000 people. So that's a huge amount. And we've got people coming in from Spain, France, Germany and Denmark for this event. And people have travelled all down from Liverpool, Brighton, all over the country for this event. And they're all here at the crack of dawn, 6:30 in the morning for a 7 o'clock start. And it's just been awesome. And I'm going to pass you back to Steve Woody now because I've been talking too much.
Can I just say, though, to finish that off, that everyone in this room, and as you look around, they're all here because of you. I know there's a lot of factors in place, but all of this is because of you. Because of what you've done. Thank you.
Thank you very much. But it's not just about me. You know, we've got the Yes Group behind us, obviously, with this. This has come from a Tony Robbins initiative. And the Yes Group support me. And, you know, it's a great big team of us. So I've organised it. But, you know, I do have a lot of support from other people within the Yes Group. So, you know, I'm grateful. So thank you. How do you do this? I can't remember.
I don't know.
My boobies might be jumping.
So, I think Anita's going to have a little dance. I think we should get everyone going. Should we get, I'm going to get on stage, let's see if we can get everyone jumping. Come on then, up. All right, ready? Ready? Alan, go on.
Flash off!
What are we doing?
Everybody
come around.
How do you do that?
I don't know. Right. One half this time. We didn't go the other way. Crisscross. We need to go the other way.
Right.
Oh.
Hands
on your
knees.
Touch up. Okay. One, two, three, four, five. Everybody clap your hands! Woo! Come here. Sorry, I might be a bit out of breath. I've just been dancing. There's some energetic kids in here. I don't know if you can see up on the projector here, but this is the map of London, all of the postcodes, and this just gives you an idea of the reach that we have this year, from SW20 all the way up to E4, all around London. We're going to be delivering baskets. I'm going to take you over now to the logistics area, and so that you've got the area, you've got an idea. As you can see now, this is the breakdown of what the area is. So you can see we've actually broken it down into smaller areas. We're going to go through now. They've actually, the logistics team have written out all of the addresses of people that are in need. So obviously we can't film the addresses for obvious reasons, but I can just show you and give you an idea just so that you can see how many families that we're going to be helping. You're going to have to follow me through the the stage area. So now what you're seeing, these are the people now. These are the people that are starting to, we'll get away from the speaker. These are the people that are starting to get ready now so that they can actually go out and deliver the first lot of baskets. And you can just get an idea of the bundles there. These are the postcodes. Each one of these pieces of paper has got an address and a name. And so we know exactly who we're delivering to. And as you can see, there's thousands of them lined out. So just to give you an idea of how we're doing so far, I don't know if we've got a count yet. I'm going to see if I can find one. In fact, Mindy's over there counting. We're going to go and see Mindy. I'm going to go and get an account from her and find out exactly how many baskets we have here. So just bear with me a second, because I don't want to stand on any of these amazing hampers. I'm joined with Mindy Gibbon-Klein, the book midwife, who is, rather than counting the numbers in books today, she's actually counting the numbers of hampers we've got. Mindy, you're doing an amazing job.
I'm not doing anything, I'm just counting. I'm watching people making baskets, bringing baskets, putting them all on the floor with lots of love. We've actually done 1,400 plus. We're more than halfway towards
already?
Our goal. Yes.
1,400 baskets already.
Already. Yeah.
That is amazing.
And there's loads more coming. I can see them. So, you know, we're definitely going to hit our target really soon.
Oh, that is amazing. So these are going to start to go out now so that the next lot can come through.
Absolutely.
And what's the time? What time are we on now?
It is only 11:40.
It's not even 12 o'clock. 11:40 in the morning. What have you done today to make a difference? 11:40 in the morning and we've got nearly 1,500 baskets. This is amazing.
Amazing.
Thank you so much. So, as Ian's just announced on stage, this year, 3 times bigger than anything we've done before. Logistically, we've never done anything like this before. There's a lot of growing pains, but it's been amazing. We've coped, we've grown, and everyone's worked so well together. The thing is, what I've learned more than anything is, yeah, there may be a system in place, and that system might not work, but the fact that there is a system there and it can be tweaked, and that it can be tweaked live, and that everyone is willing to adapt. When people come together, amazing things happen. And as you look around the room and you see such a diverse group of children, older people, race, religion, everything's mixed. There's no bias in this room at all. There's no ego in this room. Everyone's got an agenda, but today that agenda is unified and everyone is doing it for the one purpose, to help and to contribute, to feel good at Christmas that you've made a difference in somebody else's life. And I think that sort of personifies what Basket Brigade is all about. The fact that we can make a difference to somebody else, no matter what you've got, whether you've got millions in a bank or whether you've got pennies, the fact that you can come and you can give your time to help make somebody else's Christmas a better experience, that's the sort of love and connection that you can't buy that with money. That's the sort of thing that the connection that you have with other like-minded people is what makes this day so special. So if you didn't get a chance to get down this year, please, 2014, the details, I'm sure they'll be online soon enough. Make sure that it is on your bucket list, that once in your life, at least, you do something like this to make a difference. Thank you.